give you such a crick in the neck.
Whoa!
So what'll it be, Master?
I must have hit my head harder than I thought.
On every character that you're animating, no matter whether it's a mermaid or a beast or an eagle or it's Aladdin, it has to be something that I've experienced personally.
Genie, I wish for you to make me a prince.
All right! Hang on to your turban, kid. We're gonna make you a star.
Prince Ali, Majesty Ali Ababa.
In terms of my own work in animation, whatever it's going to be, it has to challenge me and push me to something that I haven't done before. I mean, there's so much to explore in this world and see in what God has created. I just want to keep looking and discovering and doing that reflection of, you know, where you see something and you reflect it back to the audience. That's what I want to do, and I want to do that all the way to the day I die. I think that I will.
Walt Disney Pictures, The Little Mermaid.
Glen Keane is leidinggevend tekenaar bij Walt Disney. Hij is de succesvolle ontwerper van De Kleine Zeemeermin, Het Beest uit de populaire tekenfilm Belle en het Beest, en ook van Disney's nieuwste held,
Aladdin.
You're a genie?
That's right, he can be taught.
You never feel like me.
My dad is a cartoonist. He draws the family circus. It's in about 1,400 newspapers in America. And to me, it was the most natural thing in the world to want to be an artist when I grew up. And that's always what I've wanted to be. Ever since I can remember, I've drawn. I've always been just drawing, like my dad. And so then all the way up through school, I drew. And then I really got interested in sports and football. And by the time I graduated from high school, I had a choice of either go to play football for Arizona State University or to go to art school. And I sent my portfolio to art school out in California that Walt Disney had started. And I got a letter back saying that I was accepted into the School of Film Graphics. And I found out that film graphics was a kind of a fancy way of saying cartoons. That's what it was. It was animation. And I discovered that animation was a combination of all the arts together. It was singing, music, design, drama, drawing, painting, everything rolled into one. And I just fell in love with it. After 2 years at CalArts, though, Disney had started a training program searching for artists all around the country to bring in to replace the old guys who had done Pinocchio and Snow White. Actually, they were looking for somebody to replace themselves, somebody that they could pass the baton on to. And so my first picture was The Rescuers.
Op mijn liefste Bernard en onze verrukkelijke samenwerking.
Ja, verrukkelijk, ja, verrukkelijk.
Wat ben je toch stil vanavond? Is er soms iets met je?
Nou, eigenlijk. Ik vroeg me af.
Ja, lieverd.
Ik. Juffrouw Bianca, wilt u mij even excuseren?
The director said, well, can you draw? You know, a cute little 16-year-old girl? I mean, you draw bears and giants and rats and things. I said, no, I've been drawing my wife for 15 years now. I could draw her. I think I could do that. He said, well, okay, we'll give it a try. And so then that was my first step, was to design Ariel.
Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more.
Little Mermaid was based on my wife, Linda. You know, she's got kind of this perky little nose and a smile. And Ariel's pointy chin. She has that girl next door kind of a look. You know, I mean, she's my best friend. At the end of the day, it's the one thing that can pull me away from my board to go home to be with her and my kids, and Claire and Max. But I base Ariel on her.
Street, up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun, wandering free. Wish I could be part of that world.
Met groot geduld werkt Glen aan een tekening van de kleine zeemeermin. Eén tekeningetje is klaar. Maar een animatiefilm als De Kleine Zeemeermin bestaat uit meer dan 100.000 tekeningen. Computers spelen een steeds belangrijke rol in het maken van de tekenfilm. Maar hoe dat gebeurt is een geheim dat Disney zorgvuldig bewaart.
So Beast's head is generally a buffalo shape. But then I went to the LA Zoo and I was drawing these gorillas. And they have this great, strong, powerful brow that comes over like this. These massive brow muscles. And so I thought, well, that would be great to get that. And they also have this crest on top of their head. Actually, the jaw muscles attach up there, which gives them a real powerful jaw. The eyes are the eyes of a man, though, because it's the window into Beast's soul, into his heart. You have to believe that there's a young man trapped inside this beast's body. And so it's when you look into his eyes that Belle knows there really is somebody in there that she can love. Even though he's kind of tragic and sad, you can feel that in the way he hangs his head. But it just makes it that much more wonderful when he transforms and he's able to stand erect and lift his head up, and now he's the prince, you know, transformed from this beastly body.
Vanavond is het zover.
Ik weet echt niet of ik het wel kan.
Wees vooral niet verlegen, maar wees juist doortastend.
Doortastend.
Most of the great Disney stories are based on a theme of transformation, of a character wanting to be something that's impossible, like with Beast. You wanted to see that with Ariel, see her transform into a human in the end, with Cinderella with the beautiful dress, you know, where she becomes the princess.
Voilà! Is het er zo? Zo?
Stom uit.
The greatest stories are about our own transformation. I mean, a lot of it is based on Christian parables about God transforming the inside of our life, you know, into something that we can't become without his power. And a lot of the stories, the original fairy tales, were based on these kind of truths, and that's why they're so timeless.
Iets dat altijd weer zoveel teders heeft. Iets dat elk van hen voor het eerst beleeft en hun vleugels geeft.
De Disney Studios zijn uitgestrekt en imposant. Het hoofdgebouw wordt als het ware gedragen door de zeven dwergen. Meer dan 5000 mensen werken op het uitgestrekte terrein om via de film sprookjes levend te maken.
There's a lot of development that goes into a picture. Over on this side we have some of the backgrounds from Snow White. I mean, every one of them is like a beautiful painting. Any one of these artists could have been a great painter in his own right. And any, matter of fact, most of the artists here at Disney could have been a great artist in their own right, but they've given up something of themselves to do something bigger than any one person, one artist could do alone. You have about 600 people working on an animated film like Aladdin, and when it's up on the screen, there's one name on it, it's Walt Disney. He's not even alive, but it's a dream that he started that we all keep following along the line. Everybody's willing to give something of themselves up. For me, it's to be Aladdin is a great, you know, challenge. Here, this is a scene that I animated from the picture, and it shows, you know, how the drawing is colored. The computer actually fills in all the color on the different drawings. Here, these would be some of the rough drawings. These are actually Xeroxes of the rough. And somebody will take my drawing that I did, and there's 24 of these for every second, and they will trace over top of that and turn it into a very clean line like this. This is a cleaned up version of that. And then it goes and it's colored. So these are the different attitudes. Here, I think Aladdin is saying something, but she's got these eyes. Oh, yeah. Here he says, these eyes. I remember acting that out in my room, and if you had come in to see me, saying, oh, she's got these eyes and this hair, and she's, you know, you believe it. You are him at that moment. And it's embarrassing if somebody walks in the room and you're doing that. You know.
Don't you dare close your eyes.
Yeah, these are the characters that we did sculptures for in Aladdin. We always use sculptures as a way of seeing what the character is going to look like from three dimensions. Like, I'll do a drawing of this pose of Aladdin, which I did, and Kent Melton came in and took those drawings and started doing the sculpture of Aladdin. He'd come back and we'd refine the nose. It's a little too pointy, or it's a little too, you know, curved, and we'd adjust it with Jeffrey Katzenberg going over it as well, you know, making his comments. And pretty soon we've got a sculpture that's, you know, as close as we can get to Aladdin in a three-dimensional way, and each animator has it to work with.
And Tom Cruise was a role model, huh?
Tom Cruise was a big influence on Aladdin.
Why?
Well, he has that, there's kind of this little devilish grin and a smile, you know, on his face. You can tell this guy is good, but there's something that is not, he's a little dangerous at the same time, you know. You're not sure your mom would want your sister to go out with him, maybe.
Did the actor actually come in to model or not?
No, this is just based on, I looked at Top Gun and actually drawing other volleyball players down at Manhattan Beach. And also based him a little bit on Michael J. Fox character. And of course, he had to be the handsome, heroic character, so I based him a lot on myself.